Okay, no response means no one has tried this. Only Yogaraj has tried this. Okay, so let's start with this question. I am focusing on this because it was asked in the board examination. Remember that. Okay. So over here two cells are there. First one is of 10 volt and second one is of 5 volt. So let I amount of current is coming out of this first cell of 10 volt. The same amount of current must enter in the cell. Now at junction point A, suppose I1 current that is passing through this 4 ohm resistance, and in this branch, AB branch, the current will be I minus I1. Now from this second cell, suppose I2 amount of current is coming out, the same amount of current must enter in this cell at junction point B. From here I minus I1 current is coming, and from this second branch the current is I2, so total current over here will be I minus I1 plus I2. Now at junction point C, see out of this current, the I current has gone in the branch CA. So the rest of the current that will be I2 minus I1. So I2 minus I1 current is passing through branch CD. Now at this junction point D, I1 current is entering over here, and from here it is I2 minus I1. So addition of these two, I1 plus I2 minus I1, that will be equal to I2. So you can say only the I2 current is passing through this 5 volt cell or battery. Now three variables are there, so we need at least three equations to solve this problem. So first of all, I am taking the loop A, B, C, A. Now from A to B, in the direction of current we are moving, so there will be negative potential drop 4 I minus I1. Now from branch B to, in the branch B to C, we are moving in the direction of current, so again minus twice of I minus I1 plus I2. Now from C to A the current is I, the resistance is 1, again in the direction of current we will write 1 into I. Now cell minus to plus, it is increasing, so plus 10, total will be 0. Further we can write this as minus 4i plus 4i1 minus 2i plus 2i1 minus 2i2 minus I plus 10 equals to 0. Now 4i and 2i and I, so that will be minus 7i. 4i1 plus 2i1, 6i1. Now the next is I2, only 2i2 is there, so minus 2i2 plus 10 equals to 0. Further, we can write this as 7i minus 6i1 प्लस टू आई टू इक्वल्स टू 10, दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर 1. स्टूडेंट गो थ्रू दिस इक्वेशन नंबर 1 एंड टेल मी इफ देर इज एनी डाउट रिगार्डिंग दैट.
नो सर।
Okay, now the second loop we are going to take, the second loop I am taking as A D C A. From A to D, in the direction of current, resistance is 4 and current is I1, so it will be minus 4 I1. Now from D to C, now this time we are moving opposite to the direction of current, so we have to write plus 2 I2 minus I1. Now from C to A, C to A again resistance is there and a cell is there, so in resistance it will be 1 into I. And battery minus 2 plus, so plus 10 volt, total 0. Now this minus 4 I1 and this minus 2 I1, that will be minus 6 I1, then plus 2 I2 minus I plus 10 equals to 0, or moreover you can write this as 6 I1 plus 2 I2. I am writing minus I first. Sorry, this will be I plus 6 I1 minus 2 I2 equals to 10. Let this is equation number 2. Anyone is having doubt in this equation number 2, can ask.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now next we deal with third loop. Now the third loop that I am taking over here, that is B C D including the cell E and then again B. So over here now in this loop, we will write from B to C, so in the direction of current, so we'll write minus twice of I minus I1 plus I2. Now from C to D, we are moving in the direction of current, so again minus twice of I2 minus I1. Now D to B, from D to B only there is a cell of 5 volt. So we will write minus 2 plus, that is plus 5 volt equals to 0. Now over here it is minus 2i plus 2i1 minus 2i2 minus 2i2 plus 2 I1 and plus 5 equals to 0. Now you can see, first of all there is I which is minus 2 I here, then I1, 2 I1 plus 2 I1 will be 4 I1. Next is I2, minus 2 I2 and minus 2 I2 माइनस 4 I2 प्लस 5 इक्वल्स टू 0, और वी कैन राइट दिस एज प्लस 2 I माइनस 4 I1 प्लस 4 I2 इक्वल्स टू 5। दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर 3। स्टूडेंट, इज देर एनी डाउट इन दिस थर्ड इक्वेशन?
नो
ओके, नाउ सी, वी आर हैविंग थ्री इक्वेशंस, सो वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस, दीज थ्री इक्वेशंस। सो आई एम राइटिंग दीज थ्री इक्वेशन ऑन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। So now these three equations I have written. Now it is easily visible that the first two equations, if we add these two equations, okay, first two equations. So this 2 I2 and this 2 I2 cancel, 6 I1 minus 6 I1 cancel. So 7 plus 1, 8 I1, we will have, sorry, 8 I equals to 10 plus 10, 20. Then 4, 2 is 8, and then 4, 5, 20. So value of I we are getting 2.5 amps. Is it clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now we will substitute these value in any two equations. I am choosing this first one and the last one. Okay, so when we will substitute the value, 6 I1 minus 2 I2 equals to 10 minus I will be there. So 10 minus I is 2.5. So the 6 I1 minus 2 I2 that is equal to 7.5. okay, say this is equation number 4. Okay, this value I have substituted in the first equation. I am substituting the value of I in this last equation. Okay, so over here this is what, minus 4 I1 plus 4 I2, and it is going to be 5 minus 2i. So 5 minus 2i, I is 2.5. further it is 5 minus 5, that is 0. It means minus 4 I1 plus 4 I2 is 0. That gives the result I1 equals to I2. Let this is equation number 5. Now we will substitute this value I1 equals to I2 in equation number 4. Okay, so 6 I1 minus. Now 2i2, instead of i2 we will write i1. So 6i1 minus 2i1 equals to 7.5. So 4i1, that is 7.5 amps. So value of i1 will be 7.5 divided by 4, which is 1.875 amps. Same, because I1 equals to I2, so value of I2 is same. So student, is it clear this question?
Yes sir.
Remember that this question was asked in board examination and it is given in your NCERT also. Okay, so this was the question. Now similarly, one more question is there in the CBSE board examination, so we will do that question also. It was asked in 2015, so I am changing the slide and we will continue with that. Okay, see here, what is the question given to us? This is given to you 1 volt, this is 2 ohm, this is 6 volt, 4 volt, 3 volt, this is R1 and this is R, and this one is 3 ohm, and they have marked these points as A, B, C, D, E and F. Now listen to the question. What is the question? Use Kirchhoff's law to determine the potential difference between point A and D. We have to find the potential difference between A and D. When no current flows in the branch BE, in branch BE, the current flowing in the branch BE is 0. So this is the condition given to us. When the current in branch BE is 0, what is the potential difference between A and D? Okay, so now over here, see, first of all we will check the current distribution. So I consider from here the first cell. Suppose I amount of current is coming out of this cell, same amount of current must enter over here. This I current will pass through this 3 ohm resistance, and out of that I, because it is telling there is no current in this branch BE. Remember that here in this branch no current is there. So I write 0 amps current for this. So if we see this I current which is coming in 3 ohm resistance, the same current is going to flow in this next branch D to C, that is I only. Same current will enter in this cell, same current is coming out of that. Further, the same current will enter over here in 6 volt. So mean to say this branch BE will not have any current. Now over here, we will take the loop AF EBA. AFEBA. Why I have chosen this one? Because here if we choose the another loop, the value of R is not given. That's why we have taken this loop only. Now from A to F, we are moving in the direction of current. So minus 2 into I. Then from negative terminal of cell to the positive terminal of cell, so plus 1 volt. Again in the direction of current, minus 3I. Now because in this branch B to E or E to B there is no current, so here the potential drop will be 0. But over here we are moving from minus to plus, so that we will write plus 3 volt. Further from B to A in the direction of current, and here we are moving from minus to plus, so plus 6 volt, and we have reached to point A, so total will be 0. So now minus 2i and minus 3i will be minus 5i. 1 plus 3 plus 6, that is 10 volt, total 0. So the 5i, that is equal to 10. So current we are getting, that is 2 amps current. Now with the help of this expression, we are going to derive the potential difference between A and D. So we will start from A. Okay, so we write VA. Now in the direction of current, we are moving from A to D. We can move from AFD path, or we can move from ACD path. So I am taking this AFD path. So first I have written VA. Now in the direction of current, negative 2i. Now here cell is there, cell minus 2 plus, plus 1 volt. Now F to E, again in the direction of current, minus 3i. Now E to D, there is no resistance, so we will write potential minus Vd equals to 0. Student, why I have taken this minus sign? Because with respect to A, D is at lower potential, okay, and current is moving from A to F and F to D. That means A is at higher potential, D is at lower potential. That's why we have taken here minus sign. Now this is VA minus 5i plus 1 minus VD equals to 0. So VA minus VD is equal to 5i minus 1. Now value of I is 2 amps. So 10 minus 1, that is 9 amp current. Sorry, 9 volt. So potential difference between A and D, that is 9 volt. Student, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Remember that this question was asked in the CBSE board exam 2015. Okay. So it was very simple question, but little bit tricky, that R1 and R was given to you. Now, one more similar question we are going to do, and in that question they have provided us the capacitors, remember that, and we have not done the separately any question which is having the resistance as well as capacitor. So let's do that question. So circuit is visible to you. Okay, now what was that question they asked? We have to find the potential difference across the capacitor. It means over here on the capacitor we need potential difference. Let this is V1. Now first of all student, the basic concept related to this is that capacitor that always blocks DC. Okay, it means it will not allow direct current to pass through it. It means the branch in which capacitor is attached, the current will not flow in that branch. This is the basic concept. It means in branch BE, the current will be zero. Okay, so with the help of this concept, we will be able to solve this question. Now, two cells are there, sorry, three cells are there of voltage 2 of V each and 1 2 volt. So I am considering let I amount of current is coming out of this cell. The same amount of current will enter over here. In 2 R ohm resistance, current is I. Now as we have seen that there is no current in this branch BE. So this current I will also flow in the EF branch as well as in FA branch. Again at junction B there is no current in the BE branch, so same amount of current will enter in the branch B to C. So this is the way of distribution of current. Remember that this is the basic concept that we have used. Branch which is having capacitor, in that current will be zero. Now we will take the loop. Okay, so for the loop first of all we need the value of current. So I am taking the loop A B C D E F A. Now till A to C there is no resistance. Then from C to D, first we are on the cell minus to plus, so plus 2 volt we will write. Then in 2 ohm means 2 R ohm resistance, we are moving in the direction of current, so it will be minus 2 I R. Now from D to F again there is no resistance, so we will write nothing for this branch. Now from F to A, F to A, first of all resistance is there of R ohm, so potential drop will be negative minus IR. Now here in the cell we are moving from plus to minus, so minus V, that will be equal to zero. Now students, you can see this is 2V and this is V, so 2V minus V will be V minus 2IR, and IR will be minus 3IR, that is 0. So V equals to 3IR, and value of current we are getting, that is V by 3R. So now we are having the expression of current. We can easily find the potential difference across the terminals of this capacitor. Remember that this is 2 volt and here it is 1 volt or V volt. So over here this terminal of capacitor will be positively charged and this one will have negative charge. So potential difference, to calculate potential difference again we will take the loop, and the loop is B to C, then D, E and B. First B to C there is no resistance. Now from C to D, first of all this is minus to plus, so plus 2V will write. Then in the direction of current again we are having resistance 2R, so it will be minus 2IR. Now from D to E there is no resistance. From E to B, first of all, the potential drop will be there, plus to minus, we are moving in capacitor. So minus V1 first of all. Then here on the cell, again plus to minus, minus V equals to 0. Now 2V minus V, V minus 2IR, and V1 I am transferring in the right hand side. So it will be shifted there. Now V minus 2, the value of current is V upon 3R. R, R cancel. So this is V minus 2V by 3. That is equal to V by 3. So potential difference across the ends of the terminal of this capacitor, that is V by 3. Now further in the next time when they ask the question, they also ask the energy, okay? So simple energy will be half of CV square, okay? CV1 square. So V1 is V by 3. So it will be 1 upon 2 CV square by 9. So that is the energy stored in this capacitor. This was not asked in the exams, but the next time might be, if they are asking, they can ask this also. Is this clear to everyone, or is there any doubt in that question? Okay, no one is having any doubt? Okay. Now one question I am giving you from again board examination, it was asked, but this question you will do yourself. It's very easy based on the 10th standard concept. The question was asked in 2017. What is that? Suppose there is a resistance R and it is connected with a cell of potential difference V. Okay. Now, if the heat developed across the ends of the resistor is H, what should be the new potential difference applied across the ends of this resistance so that the heat developed in it is 9 times of the initial heat generated in the resistance? Again, I am repeating the question. A resistor of resistance R is connected with voltage V and heat developed in it is H. Now, what should be the potential difference applied to this resistance in such a way that heat developed in it is 9 times of initial heat generated in it? Is the question clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so tell me,
yes, sir,
what should be the potential difference V2? Start.
Three V.
Okay.
So 3V.
Very good.
Three V.
Sir, three V.
Yes, sir. 3V.
Yeah, absolutely right.
3V. 3V.
See, this question was asked in 2 marks in CBSE examinations. Okay. So sometimes they usually ask very simple questions. Now one more question I am giving you. That question was asked in CBSE 2010. Now what is that question? It is based on the meter bridge. Okay, see over here. What is the question? In this meter bridge, the null point is found to be 60 centimeter from end A. It means somewhere here, the null point is there at balance length 60 centimeter. And the resistance connected over here, that was unknown R. Okay. Now, if a resistance of 5 ohm is connected in series with S, now next time when another resistance of 5 ohm that is connected in series to this S, the new balance point obtained, that is 50 centimeter. So, what are the values of R and S? Again, I am repeating the question. What is the question? See, in meter bridge, R and S, two unknown resistors are connected, and the null point is obtained at 60 centimeter from point A. Now, if a 5 ohm resistance is connected in series to S, then the balance point obtained is 50 centimeter. So, what are the values of R and S? Question is clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Start solving that question.
सर एक बार ये जो आपने इसके पहले वाला क्वेश्चन दिया वो कराओ ना, एक बार नहीं आ रहा था
ये हर्ष, ये वाला।
हाँ सर, उसमें थ्री भी नहीं।
ओके, बाकी लोग उस क्वेश्चन को करो। हर्ष देखो, यहाँ पे हीट का जो फॉर्मूला हमारे पास होता है, क्योंकि यहाँ पोटेंशियल फिक्स कर रखा है, तो क्या आएगा, वी स्क्वायर बाय आर इंटू टी, सही है। अब हीट को कितना करना है हमें, 9 टाइम्स करना है, तो 9h लिखेंगे, और वोल्टेज हमने वी टू लिया है, ठीक है। रेजिस्टेंस की वैल्यू चेंज नहीं कर रहे हम। अब एच का वैल्यू यहाँ सब्स्टिट्यूट करो,
सर हो जाएगा,
आ गया।
हाँ सर।
ओके, उसी टाइम पूछ लेने का, इतना वेट क्यों करते हो। ये वाला नहीं है शिष्य, देखो फर्स्ट टाइम यहां दे रखा है बैलेंस लेंथ कितना है, 60, तो यहां रिमेनिंग डिस्टेंस कितनी होगी, 40। ओके, अब यहां देखिए व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज में नल पॉइंट है, तो सबसे पहले हम क्या लिखेंगे, आर अपॉन 60 इक्वल्स टू एस अपॉन 40, करेक्ट। फर्दर इसको सॉल्व करेंगे तो आर बाय, यहाँ आप कैंसिल करेंगे इसको तो 3, और यहाँ आपके पास 2, ठीक है। सेकेंड टाइम एस के साथ सीरीज में फाइव फॉर्म है, मतलब टोटल कितना हो गया एस प्लस फाइव, और बैलेंस लेंथ आप कितना आ रहा है 50, मतलब दोनों साइड 50 50 हो गया।
यस सर।
नाउ दिस टाइम आर बाय 50 इक्वल्स टू एस प्लस फाइव बाय 50 50 कैंसिल। अब आर की वैल्यू कितनी आ रही है हमारे पास, 3s बाय 2 है फर्स्ट इक्वेशन से, ठीक है। आर 3s बाय 2 इक्वल्स टू कितना, एस प्लस फाइव, तो 3s बाय 2 माइनस एस इज 5, तो एस बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू 5, तो एस का वैल्यू कितना आ गया 10 ओम। अब एस की वैल्यू 10 है तो आर कितना है, 3s बाय 2 है
15।
यस, सो आर विल बी,
डोंट कॉपी।